Hi, welcome to this video on solving of quadratics or solving quadratic equations. If you want to pause the video, take down these 4 points. Once you've done that, then you can focus on the maths and we can get going. All right, so assuming you've done that, so solving quadratics is pretty much like solving normal equations. If I had 2x plus 1 equals 9, something like that, you should be able to solve that pretty easy. If you haven't, have a look at my solving of linear equations, and that will help you out when you do this. Obviously, I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides, so I end up with 2x equals 8, and then I divide both sides by 2x equals 4. Okay, so you should be familiar with that. To get started though, if I told you that I had a value a and a value b, two variables there, and I told you that when I multiplied them together, I got 0. Now you don't know what a and b are, but you, if I were to ask you to tell me something about a or b, you could tell me that either a or b must equal 0. Okay. I don't know what they are. I mean, a could be 25 and then B is 0, or B could be minus 30 and A is 0, but I know that at one point they have to be 0, because the only way I can get out 0 when I multiply two numbers together is if they are 0, or one of them is 0, or both. They could both be 0. Alright, so this will, in fact, I'll put this up here because this will come into play in a moment. Alright, you need to be able to solve, or I mean sort of factorize quadratic expressions. If you can't, please have a look at my video on solving of quadratic expressions, factorizing quadratic expressions, because it's very important when we're solving that we're able to do that. Okay, so the first one we're going to have a look at, if I have x squared plus 11x plus 10 equals 0. Now, it must be in this format. It must be in the format of ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. And this 0 here is very, very important. They could have given, the question could have been something like plus 12, and this could have said equals 2, or it could have said plus 10x, and that could have been 2 minus x, something like that. But either way, I need to then get it into the format where I have 0 on the other side. So in this case, I subtract 2 and add x on both sides. So subtract 2 and add x on both sides. And I end up with my original equation, x squared plus 11x plus 10. Okay? And then I'm going to just factorize this as normal. So I know that factorizes out to 2 brackets. I've got my x squared. I've got my x and my x value to give me my x squared value. I think what are the factors of 10 that will add together to get me 11? And obviously that is just 10 and 1. Both of them must be positive. And I keep this equal sign here, equal 0. I don't forget about it, because then we can just end up, that's the end of our question. We forget what we're actually trying to solve. And I'm going to bring our attention back to this a times b equals 0. If I were to make it, very obvious, what we've actually got here, I could rewrite that. I've actually got 2 brackets times each other gives me 0. And that's exactly what I have here. So what I could say at this point is either A equals 0 or B equals 0. All right, and if I were to add those brackets that I put in, you can very clearly see what I'm about to do. I could say that either this bracket, x plus 1 equals 0, or this bracket, x plus 10 equals 0. And then I just solve these linear equations separately. So now I'm going to subtract 1 from both sides, so x equals negative 1. Or I subtract 10 from both sides, x equals negative 10. So then I can say that x is equal to negative 1 or negative 10. And at this point, you'll notice that we've got 2 answers here, and that's totally fine. When you have a look at the video on plotting quadratic graphs, you'll understand exactly what these 2 numbers represent. So it's all right that we get our 2 answers for x. And if you substituted negative 1 into this original equation, or this equation here, or you substituted negative 10 in, you would actually get the exact same answer. All right, so you can, experiment with that. You could say that you'd actually get both of these. You substitute a negative 1 or negative 2, you get up to 0. Alright, let's try a couple more. So we've got x squared minus x minus 12.
X squared minus x minus 12 equals 0.
Same steps, we're going to factorize this out.
We get an x in the first, x in the second. I'm looking for factor pairs that will give me negative 1, because remember there's a 1 here. That's going to be 4 and 3. That's going to be negative and that's going to be positive. I can do this pretty quickly because I've done thousands of these.
If it takes you a little bit of time, that's totally all right. It will get easier the more of them that you do. And then now I can let each of these brackets equal 0. So I can say x minus 4 equals 0, or x plus 3 equals 0. And then I just solve these linear equations very easily. X minus x equals minus 3. So I can say x equals 4 or minus 3. You must have this statement here to show that you understand it can be either of these solutions. And you can check yourself by substituting them back in here, and you'll then get out 0 if you substitute in either of them. Okay, last one. I'm just putting this one in here to show you that it actually, this will also work when you have a coefficient of x squared, in other words, your a value, when you have your a value being something other than 1. So let's put in here 3x squared plus 5x minus 2. Right? Equals 0, because we're not solving anything. Okay, so I can see straight away that I'm going to have 3x in here and an x in here to get my x squared value. Only two factors of 2 is 1 and 2, so I'm now going to decide which goes where, because I want to get 5x out. So if I multiply 3 by 2, that's going to give me 6. 6 take away 1, brilliant, so that's going to go there. And that's going to have to be a minus, that's going to have to be a plus. I'll just confirm that. I get minus x here, plus 6x, combine that, end up with plus 5. Okay. And then I just, don't forget that's equal to 0, and then I solve each of these separately. So I've got 3x minus 1 equals 0, or 2 plus x equals 0. If we solve on this side, x equals minus 2, I'd add 1 to both sides, so 3x equals 1. This just happens to be another step, it doesn't necessarily have to solve in one step, and it's just x equals 1, and I'm going to divide both sides by 3, so 1 divided by 3. So I can say x equals 1 third, or minus 2. Okay. Don't be put off by the fact that you've got a 3x there. It's just as, you know, having a fraction there is totally acceptable. And it will come up quite a lot. So I've got three ones for you to solve. Have a go. Pause the video now. Let me hold it quite close there. Pause the video now, have a go, and I will get the answers out for you. All right, assuming you've done that, here are the answers. The answers for question A. You solved that, and you ended up with x equals negative 2 or negative 5. Yep. Answer for question B, x equals negative 1 or 5. Okay. And then answer for question C, a little bit more challenging, because you had a two-step equation on this side with this bracket, and you end up with x equals 1 or 4. So this solves out to that. All right. Excellent. I hope you learned something, and I'll see you again next time. Cheers.